Queens, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications. So if you don't know who I am, my name is sydmcgee. This is my fiance Dylan Forsyth.
Hi.
And today we are going to do a venue walkthrough. We already chose our venue, and basically we're just gonna go back out, walk through, show you guys, because we're really, really excited about it.
Like, oh yeah.
It is like my dream venue.
It looks so good.
It has the exact vibe that I want, so I'm really excited to show you guys. So I will see you when we're in the car on our way. It was 70 degrees outside yesterday. It's snowing. I don't know what happened, but honestly, I'm not bad. Okay, I didn't take any videos in the car, but we are here. This is called the venue at Stockton Lake. It's about an hour from my house, so not too bad. And I mean, as you can tell by just looking right here, it is a beautiful, it's just like wood cabin vibes. And speaking of, there's cabins here, but I'll go into that later. Imagine me here in my wedding dress. Might even be snowing, because January, it'd be so pretty. Yay. Let's go inside. This is officially the Sydney and Dallin Forsyth wedding venue 2020, January 2020, coming at you live. Let's go inside and see it. It's a dream. Ready?
I don't think I'm ready.
I'm just gonna take you guys on a tour. The whole point of this video is to just kind of show you guys what the venue looks like and then what my dream is like, so you guys can kind of like watch this and then watch the actual wedding video in about 60 something days and see how well we did setting it up. So you first walk in and this is what the entrance looks like. It's got these beautiful barn doors. The lighting in this whole place has these really pretty like light bulbs. And then this, I love. This table has the barrels. It just has like the perfect amount of like elegance and rustic, which is exactly what I wanted. And then there's also this table, which will be like the gift table. So we'll do the guest book on that table and then the gifts and cards on that table. Now this is what the actual full venue looks like. Sorry, they're having a conversation up there. So this is the main floor. So the plan is, I will take you upstairs after this, but the bridal room is upstairs, so I'll walk down the stairs, and then we'll have all the chairs set up right here, and an aisle runner, and so I'll walk down the aisle here, and then by the windows behind you, I'll have an arbor, and then we'll probably have like some sort of slideshow videos playing on these two TVs. Okay, so the plan is that after I walk down the aisle, we're gonna go outside and take pictures, and then my family will like move all the chairs out of the way, and we'll have our sweetheart table right here. And I'm still debating if I want our bridal party to sit next to us, but if we do, we'll do the sweetheart table in the middle, and then them on the two sides, and then we'll probably put the cake dessert table over here too, because you know how people are, they don't realize that you're not supposed to eat the really fancy cake until you have the cake cutting, so we need it like away from the food. We'll have the DJ system set up on this wall over here, and then in these other two pillars, we'll just have like some round tables with chairs, so there's eating options downstairs and upstairs, because I know like my grandma, for instance, probably won't be able to walk up the stairs because they're pretty steep. And then we'll have some more tables in these two pillars. So we'll probably have about four tables downstairs. One of my favorite things about downstairs, well, about the whole place, it's not just downstairs. Look at the lights. As I talked about, like all the lights are like little light bulbs, and these string lights are like everything I ever imagined at my wedding. Like, I was like, ooh, when I get married one day, I wanna have those like string light bulbs. They're already here. Amazing. Okay, so this is where we're gonna have the food. There's a kitchen in there. Let me just go ahead and take you in. Welcome to the kitchen. Okay, so this is where the kitchen is. It's in the corner, and there's actually a back entrance for the caterer to come in. And there's like ovens, microwaves, fridge, everything you need to like heat stuff up and all that jazz. Trash cans right here, great. I really like this because like no matter what kind of wedding you're doing, whether you're doing buffet style, it'd be an easy way to heat stuff up and then put it over. Or if you're doing actual catering, then the waiters, whatever you call them, can come up and like grab them from here because it's like a window. So I think this kitchen is really cool. So I showed you the kitchen. We'll put a long table right here and have like buffet style food. We don't know what kind of food we're gonna get yet. We're gonna talk to caterers like probably this month sometime. Yeah, I don't really know what else to say. Pretty basic stuff. So this place is so nice that even the bathrooms are amazing. So there's two bathrooms downstairs and then some in the bridal room upstairs. But come on in.
Oh, we're going kinda in weird, the bathroom.
But we're going in the bathroom. Hi.
Hi guys.
Talon's here. I don't know if you knew that. So the bathroom is even like barn vibes. I won't like show you in the stall, but look how cute the barn doors are. And like even the sinks, like I wish I had this sink at my house. These are beautiful. And the mirrors. And there's really good lighting. This whole place has amazing lighting.
Oh,
which
yeah.
is very important on your wedding day. It's not like fluorescent bright. It's like moody lighting, like kind of dim. And then they've got a lot of natural light, which is great.
You want to show the boys' bathroom off?
Not really, but ta-da, who cares? Ugh, boys. Okay, so this is the bar area. As you guys probably know, we don't drink. My family doesn't drink. Not a drinker. I'm not even 21, so. But I mean, we could put our hot chocolate over here.
Oh,
so
yes.
Hot chocolate bar. If you're wondering why it's called the venue at Stockton Lake.
Oh, do I need to look?
Because there's a lake and it's Stockton Lake. Stockton Lake is right there. You can see it, so that's why it's called that. But okay, there's something else really dope about this venue that's not even the venue is that there are, I believe, 33 cabins for rent on the site. It's like literally right behind here, there's a bunch of cabins. And there's cabins that fit 18 people and there's cabins that fit 2 people. Okay, so also at the venue, they have a lot of different entrances. So there's like 3 that are right here. Me and Don are low-key hoping it snows because well, this is the first snow of the year, which is awesome that I'm filming it on the first snow of the year. But it looks really, really pretty, and getting married with like that in the background would be gorgeous, and then taking pictures in the snow would be awesome. So that'd be really cool if it did snow, but if it didn't, we could do stuff outside if it was warm or whatever. So I just want to show you guys that like, you can just walk out any of these doors. And even the outside is really cool. So there's these like benches that people can sit on. They even have cornhole back there, if you can see that cornhole right there. And then there's like a bench over here. And this like whole porch thing wraps around the whole thing to the other entrance. And if you're getting married outside, let's just zoop over there really quick. Zoop? What? Zoop? I don't know.
Let's go, Sydney, it's freezing.
Just right here. So, show them the outside. If it's warm and you want to get married here, then there you go. If it happens to be nice, maybe I'll do that, but I doubt it will be. So yeah, and then there's like a campfire right there, which is kind of
and cool. A cute little pond.
Oh my gosh, it's snowing. Look how pretty it looks right here. The venue at Stockton Lake. As we are planning on live streaming either on my YouTube or on my Instagram, I'll have more information coming soon, closer to the wedding, but we will be live streaming it. So don't worry, you're not gonna miss out just cause you're not here. Let's go back.
All right, I was about to say, I'm not standing out here any longer.
So out of respect for me, Dallin, and our families, we hope that this can be an invitation only, family and close friends only. We send out invitations to every single person we want here. So yeah, I just feel like I want to say that because we don't want a bunch of random people showing up. But that doesn't mean that we don't want you guys to be participating in everything. We'll be live streaming the whole thing. We just want it to be a close, family-centered event. So I hope you guys can respect our wishes, and we love you.
Okay, it's hot.
Let's go upstairs. Welcome to upstairs. Woo! Ow. I drank a Red Bull and I need to breathe and I can't. I'm talking so fast. Okay. As you can see, there are really, really pretty stairs. As I said, I'm gonna walk down them right into where the arbor is and get married over there. Oh, I can't breathe. One of the things that literally made me want this venue is because of the stairs. Because I always see like in movies, like when like the girl comes out in a really pretty dress, like Cinderella vibes, and you walk down the stairs. I just think it's gonna be really, really cute. So I'm really excited about that. And of course I'll have my dad escort me so I won't have to worry about tripping down the stairs. So another thing that really made me love this venue besides everything is the bride and groom's room. So let's look at the bride. So in the bride's room, I'm gonna have 6 bridesmaids. There's plenty of room for everyone. There's seating, and then the dopest part is look how good the lighting is in the vanities. Like, does everyone not dream of having a vanity like this, like, every day to get ready? It's beautiful. And then they also have these things, literally hang up my dress, hang up the bridesmaid dresses, it's beautiful. I need to sit here and test this out.
Okay.
Because this is where I'm gonna be. Oh, I'm kinda short, it's okay. It's so perfect, it's so perfect. And there's like so many outlets, it's perfect. So they also have like the biggest mirror in the history of mirrors, like, it's huge. That's perfect. So I can see my final look in the mirror. I look good today. Of course, as every bridal room should have, there's a bathroom. Because the number one tip I've read is to make sure you go pee before you put on your dress. So I'll definitely be doing that right here. Right here, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be taking my last pee before putting on my dress. Okay, anyway. And then, yeah, okay, let's keep going. So, into the groom's room. The groom's room is a total, like, bachelor pad vibes. They have a TV, and I'm pretty sure downstairs bring his Xbox so they can, like, play games up here. And then they just have their chairs, so, yeah. My favorite part is that there's literally one mirror because the groomsmen take, like, 3 seconds to get ready. They'll just walk up and be like, bow tie, boom. Meanwhile, I'm going to be spending 4 hours in that room doing my makeup, my hair, like, must be nice, babe.
It is pretty nice, baby.
And then the guys can just like walk around, finish up doing last minute stuff.
And the doors
are really cool. Yeah. So they can close them when they're getting ready and then open them. And what we also talked about is like during the ceremony, we can just leave them open and like all the little kids could come like hang out up here or just be a chill room if people don't want to be in the middle of everything. I don't know, whatever. Okay. This is probably one of the coolest venues I've ever seen, just because of like the way the balcony is set up. Okay, I don't even know how to explain because it's my dream venue. Like this is literally everything I ever imagined in a venue. Like I literally screamed when I found it. It was amazing. Our plan is there are like 5 of these indention things that you can see. So we're gonna do 5 round tables on each side. So 10 tables upstairs, 8 chairs each one. And then in between they have high top tables. So we'll do like a high top table. If you guys know what I'm talking about, I guess you could call them like cocktail tables. Like, you know how in the movies, like the tall ones, you know what I'm saying? Okay, glad we're on the same page. That's pretty much the whole venue. How excited are you?
Very.
I know I've said it like 12 times, but this is literally my dream venue. Like I've always wanted a rustic barn type venue.
Oh, stuff.
Yes. It's ours.
And I'm like actually excited. I just realized I said very, just like very. But I am so excited, Sydney. This is gonna be so sweet, so.
I know. Dallin is just like here for the ride and I'm just planning everything, but it's working out really good. Like, I feel like you were a little worried about me choosing like the venue and everything. Like I could have chosen something super like girly, like not what you're into.
I was very scared.
But this place is so good because it's like, it could be like a bro's place, like the groomsman room, such a bro place. But then like the bride room is so girly. It's like a perfect, like versatile space to where everyone
can
do it. And all the decor that I'm doing is like not super, super girly. It's mostly greenery. It's not even a lot of flowers, which is really cool. So I can't wait for everyone to see what the wedding actually looks like completely set up. Also, I just want to add to clarify for people who are also of my religion, we're getting married in the temple the day before. If you don't know what that means, I will explain it on the day of the wedding. I just don't want to explain it a million times, so stay tuned for that video. But basically, we get like sealed. It's a very religious and very sacred ceremony in the temple, and it'll be all the way in Kansas City. And then we'll come here for our reception and ring ceremony. So we're technically having 2 ceremonies. More fun, woo! We're getting married. We're getting married and I have the perfect venue. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just really excited and I drank a Red Bull, can you tell? Woo! Okay, let's end this video. So here's my quick shout out. I wanna say thank you so much to the owners of the venue at Stockton Lake for letting us use this venue for our reception. It's gonna be absolutely beautiful and I can't wait to capture it on the day, take a million pictures and all of that. You should actually get married here. If it's a summer wedding, there's outdoor stuff. If it's a winter wedding, indoor is beautiful as well. So it's a great space and it can be set up so many different ways. It's huge, so if you have a lot of people or even not a lot of people, I don't really know what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that this place is amazing and that you should check it out. I will put a link down below in the description if you guys wanna check out this place. Or if you're just looking for somewhere to like stay that's beautiful, they have really pretty cabins that are right next to the lake. So it's a great place to stay as well. And I will link down the actual link to like the cabins as well. So you guys can check all that out. Once again, it's called The Venue at Stockton Lake. Thank you guys so much for watching this video and thank you to the owners for letting us use this space and film it and everything. And I can't wait to show you guys the actual wedding day. So I love you guys and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.